Boy, it feels good to be home. Did we get any calls, dear?
Yeah, I got this really weird telephone call. Some guy called up and wanted to know if the coast was clear. That's strange. Anyway, I told him that he must have dialed the wrong number.
Oh, no! That would probably... Oops.
What do you mean?
What do you mean?
Oops.
Mr. Clean?
Who the heck is Mr. Clean?
Not Mr. Clean. Him of all people? Boy, what a name. It doesn't fit him at all. If I had my way, I'd take him to the cleaners. And boy, I'll tell you, he'd get more than just a soft scrub when I got through with him.
You take that back. That is rude. Can't you say anything good about anybody?
Listen, young lady, I don't like that tone of voice you're using.
Well, I'm sorry, but Mom, Dad, this is a new era. You're supposed to look like that.
Well, if you ask me, he looks more like a big bully. I can't figure him out. He's always dashing out of the house like crazy. Good grief, I don't know what you see in him. Anyway, I'm having a very hard time drifting off to sleep with all this commotion.
Yeah, tell me about it. This is just like a volcano erupting and all the lava flowing out.
All right, Dad, you tell her. Now you're really getting bold.
Whose side are you on anyway? If you don't shut up and mind your own biz, I'm going to throw you in the bathtub and watch you dissolve.
Oh, I'm really scared. Oh, I gotta see this.
How dare you tell your brother to shut up? The nerve of you. Next time you say something like that, I'm going to wash your mouth out with soap.
Really? Why don't you just drop him? Forget he exists and get a fresh start.
That's it. I want out of this family. Honestly, a person would have to wear a chill to step in this house.
No kidding? Wow, that's the most incredible thing I've ever heard. When you leaving, sis?
That's enough. I think I'll vanish before things get even more soapy. I'll be back when the tide comes in.
Oh, sure. Here we go again. Every single time we have a family problem, what do? You whisk off instead of assuming your responsibilities as a father and sticking around.
Well, that's right. Do you think I get any joy out of listening to you two fight all the time? Just once, I'd like to see the sunlight in this house.
Oh, I got a perfect solution, Dad. Why don't you and me just take off and go camping somewhere, like, maybe the Cascade Mountains or something. And when old Myrtle over there finally wakes up and smells the pine saw, we'll come back and be a happy family.
Oh, isn't that fantastic? You guys have such a fabulous way of walking out all the time. Things start getting foamy around here, and away you go.
Oh, calm downy. Where's my little turtle dove that I married?
Oh, you can forget that. Can't you see this family going down the drain-o?
Oh, Mom, I almost forgot. This company called, what was the name of it? Oh, yeah, Procter & Gamble called. They said that some check that they wrote, two of them bounced.
Well, I'm sure it's not going to bounce around as much as you two.
Back to the subject. I really don't think Mr. Clean is all that bright.
Well, he's really good with his arm and hammer. When we get married, he's going to build an ivory tower right by the surf.
Yeah, well, speaking of the surf, boy, Dad. Well, how should I put this? I didn't really want to say this, but you know that Mr. Clean, that jerk that Myrtle's going out with? Well, when I went to the beach the other day, I saw him caress her head and shoulders in the tide. I'll tell you, I've never seen anybody come out of the Selston Blue so full of zest.
You don't say. Well, don't you have any pride? I thought I brought you up better than that.
Oh, how you lie, Saul. He was just giving me a dermassage. I'm scrub-free.
Somehow I vividly recall a Jack coming over. I was quite impressed with him. What happened to him anyway?
Oh, good grief, not him. All he wanted to do was tackle me.
Well, if you two can't stop this arguing, I'll make a chore girl out of you, young lady.
Oh, now I'm really scared. I'll be good.
Yeah, Dad. Hey, you know something? I just remembered. It's Myrtle's turn to mop and glow.
Hey, that's right. And this time, would you please try to remember to rinse though?
Yeah, okay, Mom. Hey, Melvin, I'd like to see what kind of a girl you're going to have for a sweetheart. With your legs, it'll be a Dutch girl.
You just wait and see, sis. She'll be dynamo. Besides, I'm more into the cheerleaders like Crystal White. Remember her? Boy, does she have the moves. Ooh, she really gets downy.
Isn't that the girl you kept out till dawn?
She sure tried to cling to you.
She did not, and that was Brick. She's so finessed, and her hair is like ivory snow. She really gives it the final touch.
I heard she bleaches her hair with Clorox. It certainly wasn't pure and natural.
Hey, now wait just a minute. How in the world did you get me involved with my girlfriend? I thought we were talking about Myrtle and her boyfriend, the creep Mr. Clean.
Well, whoever we're talking about, I'd sure like to know what we expect to gain from all this.
Well, I have had it with all this fighting. I just give up. But I want you to know one thing, dear daughter. I warned you, and if you insist on going with Mr. Clean, as you call him, let's get one thing straight. Don't send me an SOS.
Myrtle do. Will she defy her parents and go out with Mr. Clean? Or will she date the twins down the street, Johnson and Johnson?